3D printing has been around for a lot longer than most people imagine, with initial experiments taking place as early as 1981. We all thought that it would revolutionize manufacturing, but the progress has been slower than what we had hoped for. So the key shortcomings were, one, expensive, secondly, slow, and thirdly, the use of plastic as a material limited its use. Had we used metals, the outcome perhaps would have been different and the scope would have been more. But the use of metal and its alloys required very high temperatures and complex processes. So as a result of that, 3D printing was largely used for prototyping and never found its way into the floors of manufacturing facilities. At least, not until now. That narrative may be changing. Earlier this month, Volkswagen has announced that they will mass produce metal 3D components using HP's printer jet technology. So will a steel 3D printer be a game changer for the industry? Let's find out. Sumeer, Chandra, the MD of HP India, and Mr. Guruprasad, the Senior Director at Imaginarium. Over to you, a beginner's guide then.
Sure, so we are all familiar with traditional manufacturing where you take a big block of raw material and you remove material to get to the desired space, to the shape. Whereas in 3D printing, you're actually starting with nothing and you're building layer by layer the entire three-dimensional object. So 3D printing, also known as additive manufacturing, is much more efficient because it uses less material and can also be cost-optimal in a lot of scenarios. So the technology that HP has introduced, and we have the HP Jet Fusion 3D printer, is really a disruptive technology because it's a lot more productive, 10 times more productive, and at half the cost compared to similar 3D printing technologies. Now, what you see here is the heart of the printer where the actual printing happens, where our printer is creating this layer by layer on a platform. But this is not just the only part. There's also a cooling station and a post-processing station where once the part is created, we bring the build unit and we put the build unit back here where the parts are cooled in a matter of hours, then your finished product is ready. And what you get out of here is parts such as these, which is, this is the plastic coupler that has been created just from this printer. So this is the post-processing unit, and the parts, once they are produced, they are lying in the build chamber with all the raw material around it. All the raw material that's lying here, that's actually what is not used, is sucked back and recycled. So there's no wastage of the raw material here. And as you can see, this is the part that comes out of the printer. And once we clean it, and then we sandblast this product, and we get the final product that comes out of the 3D printer.
This is what the final product looks like after sandblasting.
And that's a plastic coupler that's used to join a pipe with an engine assembly.
Okay, and you can also do fun things like the two label pins that the gentlemen are wearing is also 3D printed. Well, now let's talk about the opportunities, shortcomings, and the business of 3D printing. Let's continue our conversation. So what were the shortcomings up until now, and what has changed?
The main shortcoming was really around the fact that the speed at which you could create parts was really, really slow.
Okay.
And you could not create enough number of parts. So companies would use these to create one-off parts for R&D purposes, for prototyping purposes, for testing purposes. But now with 3D, with HP's technology, one is you can create a lot more parts, a lot faster. That's
okay.
One. Second is our technology also allows you to create parts which are technical term called isotropic, which has the same strength in different dimensions. So now you actually have better quality, more robust parts that can actually go into the actual part or the end product itself. And this is really one of the big changes.
Okay, so let's talk a bit about numbers, that tie-up that Volkswagen and HP has done. So for them, how many automotive parts would you be 3D printing? And also some numbers of the kind of volumes that you will be, at least initially, what is, you know, been signed up or partnered?
So we won't speak specifically to Volkswagen as such, but if you take any car, you know, the car typically has anywhere from 6 to 10,000 parts.
Okay.
And a number of them can actually now be produced with 3D printing.
So when you say a number, are we talking about 0 to 100 or, you know, 100 to 500, 500 to 1,000? Give us some range.
No, it'll definitely be in the hundreds. So today, right now, we are able to produce a number of parts that go into a car,
okay.
Whether it's sub-assemblies, some plastic and metal parts that are kind of in the outside. In fact, some companies are even looking at using plastics or metals to actually produce engine components. So the, definitely the number will be in hundreds.
In hundreds. Yeah. And give us some examples of the kind of parts that, you know, automotive companies will look to, you know, produce via 3D printing, but on a large scale, not for prototypes.
Sure. So this will be, you know, in sub-assemblies, steering wheel assemblies, you could have several components that can be produced by 3D printing. Some of the, you know, hub caps, external body parts could be 3D printed as well. You know, there are companies that are actually trying to customize gear knobs and other decorative items in the car using 3D printing. So that's really where the exciting opportunities is. You can actually customize your car as per your individual taste.
Okay, but that would be a specialized or, you know, the specialty parts.
Right.
But for, you know, like mass usage on a very large scale, we're talking about like a million parts. What would those be?
So I don't
or
know.
Or have we reached that stage yet?
I think 3D printing would probably be less for millions of parts. It would be more for hundreds and thousands of parts.
Okay. But so you more would for find the customized and specialized parts.
Not just that, but also you can think of it as from a spare part replacement strategy. So think about a car company which has hundreds of car models. They have to keep spare parts for each of these cars for several years. And there is a lot of obsolescence and wastage and supply chain inefficiency. With 3D printing, you don't need to keep those parts in inventory. You can just print them on demand. And you can print them anywhere in the world. So all you need to do is send a digital file to the nearest printer and your spare part is printed you know, very quickly.
Okay. Mr. Guruprasad, all this is about the automotive side.
Yes.
You've been in the business for the longest time. You are India's largest 3D printing company. Tell us in terms of the Indian companies and the clients, what has been the adoption and offtake like?
I can recollect the dentist, okay. Dental community adopted 3D printing first. Though India had a large market, for everything, and then you have jewelry makers who also adapted to 3D printing. Then you have automotive companies like Maruti, the Hero Motor Corp, or the others who later on joined Indian market. They all had big facilities. Okay, that gave them a strategic advantage of going to market early, because 3D printing made making a prototype faster than ever before. And I think that was the beginning for Indian market to grow. And today, I think it is a very big market.
Do you have any numbers? How large is the 3D printing market in India?
I think Indian user market, if you take, it is around 500 crores Indian rupees. And if you take the opportunity of the market, it is very large, because we are still trying to evangelize. India is a late adapter, and people, India Inc. have a lot of what I can say, risk awareness, because of which the investments in Indian 3D printing has been very not satisfactory actually.
Okay.
So I will put the Indian total market at around opportunity at around 3,000 crores.
Sumeer, we spoke about how the productivity can be, you know, 10x.
That's right.
What about in terms of the printing speed and also in terms of the economics of it, the cost of 3D printing versus via the traditional? Any numbers?
Sure. So, as you said, the productivity for plastics is about 10x.
Okay.
In the metal printing technology that we just announced 2 weeks back, we will be 50 times faster, more productive than comparable technologies. As far as the cost is concerned, when it comes to mid to short run production, these will be more economical than mainstream traditional manufacturing, because you don't have the fixed costs upfront. But the real beauty of 3D printing is in actually optimizing the part. So what we now, currently in traditional manufacturing, your design is constrained by the manufacturing techniques, and you can't really create complex shapes in one single shot. Whereas in 3D printing, design is totally unconstrained.
So 5 to 10% of today current manufacturing facilities can be 3D printed, according to you?
Current component.
But we are not there yet.
We are not. We are clearly not there. Yeah.
Any numbers? Because the manufacturing, you know, at least what I read was the size of the manufacturing industry in the world is what, 12 trillion right now?
That's correct.
So $12 trillion.
$12 trillion, right?
So and 3D today, printing would be?
So today 3D printing is quite small relative to that.
Any
various
numbers?
Estimates put it at around $8 billion.
Okay.
And projected to grow to nearly $20 billion by 2020.
Okay.
But if you really take the entire manufacturing opportunity, there are various estimates, and there's an estimate from BCG, which is a management consulting firm, which says that if 1.5% of manufacturing were to be 3D printed, that's a $350 billion opportunity by 2035.
Okay.
So the potential in front of 3D printing is enormous.
So if I want to buy a 3D printer at home, How expensive is it and what can I use it for?
Well, 3D printer where CAD can create something is actually the real 3D printer. That comes as low as some 10,000 rupees.
And what can it do?
I mean, it is only limited by imagination what you can do. We can do anything. But what you can expect, it varies. You know, the machine what you buy for as a toy may work tomorrow, they may not work day after tomorrow.
Gentlemen, it's an absolute pleasure to chat with you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.